What's happening, family? It's your man, the Czar, the resident president of the Sim Nation. Welcome to 2K14 Strategy Session Volume 2. There is a prerequisite for today's session, and that is Strategy Session 2K14 Volume 1, where we introduce the freelance system and describe how it functions. If you're lost on any part of today's video, I highly suggest you check it out, as we will not be repeating all of that information in today's session. Let's get to work. Last time we dissected the offensive strategy menu. We know there are two options with three modifiers. We discussed the space the floor modifier, and as you can see, the nuggets are in that now. Today we'll break down the motion modifier out of the three out, two in set, as we discuss spacing the floors for those who want to create their own action. Motion is the modifier for those who like to stand in one spot and watch the AI create movement possibilities. As soon as I initiate the motion strategy by pressing D-pad to the left and pressing A on the 360, X on the PS3, my teammates immediately begin their movement. The key again is realistic, coordinated, and authentic basketball movement. The motion will create opportunities for ball movement. It's still up to you to put your players in position to score. What NBA 2K14 system does is split out the different ways that users prefer to play when not running set plays. If you want to space and create, use spacing. If you like a lot of movement and ball rotation, use motion. If you want definitive scoring opportunities, use freelance. As we look at 2K13, all of these options were combined into one system, which made it difficult to please different types of gamers. If I'm looking for off-ball movement, constant ball screens might be a problem. Then, if I did use the ball screen and someone's tendency was to cut, it would ruin spacing. You also had situations where everyone on the floor would just decide to swap sides. If you wanted to run penetrating pitch, it could be difficult if the AI decided that that was the perfect time for some random off-ball movement. Another example is a user who's waiting for motion to happen while the system is running a post-up action. As we get back to 2K14, it's clear that it delivers more freelance customization than any previous title. If you want more info on spacing, click the link below, because this train is headed for motion. One cool thing about the motion set is, if you continue moving, it functions exactly like the spacing set. Your teammates will try to maintain their spacing relationship with the basketball. This allows you to mix in penetrate and pitch with ball rotation to add different flavors to your offensive sauce. Now, a couple quick keys to mastering the motion set. Number one is knowing that once a cut has begun, the only way to cancel that movement is with a pass. Remember, the player cutting cannot react to your dribble movement until he finishes his cut. This means you could ruin spacing by dribbling to the spot he's cutting to. This is definitely one of the weaknesses of the system. This is easily avoided by playing real basketball and allowing your teammate to make his cut and then play off of that action. Unlike the spacing set, passes into the post can generate post-action cuts and screens. as well as spacing to allow the post to operate. There is also post movement actions for passes into the high post. Wrap up this session on motion. Remember, this is the NBA. It's not college. You don't have all day to score. Use the motion to get in position to make a play. The real key is to remember, if all you want is spacing, then motion is the wrong option for you. Click the link to check out our video on spacing. As noise as the motion system is, the system can falter under erratic user inputs. But I think any system that attempts to read and react user input could also suffer from the same fate. In the right hands, however, the motion system can be real noise. And that brings our time together today to a close. In strategy session one, we covered spacing. Today, we knocked out motion. We'll be back again soon to talk about the freelance modifier. If you love sports and sports video games, be sure to join us this and every Friday, 7 p.m. Eastern on Blog Talk Radio for the Sim Nation Radio Show, where we discuss basketball, video games, and life. Until next time, it's your man, the Czar, the resident president of the Sim Nation, reminding you, don't play video games, play basketball.